Hey, what's up? This is Brandon Simmons for BrandonSimmons.biz. This is my video blog called Bullheaded, a review of the Houston Texans news, as well as a preview of the upcoming game matchups. So, in this case, it's going to be a preview of the upcoming offseason, but it's already off to a crazy start. So, today the Texans have finally hired a head coach. They've hired defensive coordinator slash associate head coach, Lovie Smith. And this is after, up until 24 hours ago, nobody didn't even know Lovie Smith was going to take the job. So pretty much this whole offseason, since the season ended, basically, it's been a whirlwind of just controversy, just all types of foolishness from the Texans for the second or third year in a row. So at the season's end, they took a week to fire David Culley. Once they fired Culley, you know, there was a little bit of, you know, there was a little bit static about how that went down. And once, you know, everybody, the fans, the media got past that, then we were able to move on to some current candidates, which were seemingly suitable for this job. Those candidates included Brian Flores, Kevin O'Connell, Brian Flores, who was fired by the Miami Dolphins, Kevin O'Connell, the Rams offensive coordinator, Gerard Mayo, who was the defensive, the linebackers coach for the Patriots, D'Amico Ryans, former Houston Texan D'Amico Ryans, who was the defensive coordinator for the San Francisco 49ers at the time. So just quite a few candidates that were in the mix. In addition to somehow Josh McCown's name got thrown in there as well. So just a wide variety of candidates that you can imagine. As things progress just progress and, you know, teams are conducting their interviews and this, that, and the third, candidates begin to drop off. The Texans, they make it down to, you know, a few finalists. On their way to their finalists, picking their finalists, one of the finalists, Brian Flores, apparently he got tipped off that he lost out on a job that, you know, he didn't even interview for. And so he brought a lawsuit against the NFL, claiming, you know, that the hiring practices for NFL head coaches is like full of racial discrimination. So with that being said, this lawsuit comes out, you know, within the last week and everything. And, you know, he's been named as one of the finalists for the Texans head coaching job, in addition to Eagles defensive coordinator Jonathan Gannon and Josh McCown. McCown and Gannon being white. Over the weekend, it was reported that Gannon was informed he was no longer a finalist, and it seemed like it was coming down to him, to McCown and Flores. So McCown, apparently he was being told that, you know, he might not, he wasn't going to be chosen as the head coach. And all of a sudden, this comes like in the wake of Lovie Smith's name popping up like out of nowhere. And so, you know, the reports have been pretty consistent or pretty public about who's been in this race to become the Texans head coach. And, you know, it was quite a few, you know, black candidates that they had on board as well. So I don't think the Texans were, you know, in it to satisfy the Rooney Rule. I think they were, you know, some of these candidates, they were really trying to take serious and everything. So so fast forward to over probably up until the last 24 hours where Lovie Smith has, you know, been, you know, kind of had his name put into this coaching search for the Texans. So it seemed like it would be Lovie Smith or Brian Flores for a while. And lo and behold, today or Monday, they announced that, you know, Lovie Smith is going to become the next head coach for the Houston Texans. And so I had a bunch of thoughts, as I'm pretty sure a lot of people did once they heard this news. So my first thought, my initial thought about this, about Lovie Smith being hired, is it kind of reminded me of the David Culley hire. And so the only difference is between David Culley getting hired last year and Lovie Smith getting hired this year is resume. When David Culley got hired last year, I didn't like, you know, the resume that he had. You know, he had, you know, 40 plus years or so in the NFL as an assistant or whatever, and that's fine. But I wasn't, you know, I wasn't pleased with, you know, his last position before the Texans, which was passing game coordinator with the Ravens. And, you know, the Ravens were like dead last and throwing the ball. So, but with Lovie Smith, you know, he's actually, I mean, I obviously love his resume because it's obviously miles better, you know, compared to David Culley's. You know, Lovie Smith, he's been to a Super Bowl as a defensive coordinator. He's been to it as a head coach. You know, he has, you know, two different head coaching stints, one with Chicago Bears, one with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, with Chicago being the team that he went to the Super Bowl with. And so, you know, it seems like a real, you know, great resume. And, you know, this isn't like some far-off stuff that he'd done like 30 years ago. It's, you know, it's fairly recent and fairly consistent. You know, he was with Chicago up until, you know, he was with Chicago, you know, mid-2000s. Last job with Tampa Bay back in 2014, 2015. And, you know, he just came off of being, you know, the head coach for, you know, Illinois Illini, of Fighting Illini. So it's a really, really solid resume. In fact, you know, he's probably the highest profile name coaching candidate, you know, that the Texans has ever had coming into this head coaching position. But still, despite his resume and everything, you know, it still feels like this was something that was rushed. You know, he was just a last-minute candidate. And so my stupid, dumb theory about this is that, you know, I think, you know, what it was Flores, McCown, and Gannon, or I hope I'm saying his name right, O'Gannon or something. I'm going with Gannon. it was those three that were, you know, the finalists for this Texans job. And so, you know, maybe it was something with McCown that, you know, they kind of wanted him in, but maybe he didn't have the experience. So maybe it was really just down to Gannon and, you know, Gannon and Flores. And so, you know, when this whole lawsuit came about with Flores, I think it kind of made the Texans kind of hesitate a little bit. Because they were worried about how, you know, this would look on them if, you know, they go in a direction that isn't Flores, you know. Because, I mean, Flores already named, like, you know, a couple teams in here. I think he named the Giants as one team. He definitely named Buffalo, which was, you know, part of the, which kind of started that whole situation or whatever. But you know, I guess the Texans didn't want to be caught up in the middle of that. So, what I feel is, you know, obviously with those two coaches, you know, who were white, they were like, well, if we go either, they probably felt like, you know, if we go with either one of them, you know, it's going to be a lot of blowback, even like, especially with McCown. And, you know, a lot of fans were not feeling that McCown choice at all. So even if there wasn't no lawsuit, I think them going with McCown would have been, it just would not have been good. But if you go with a candidate like Gannon, you know, who obviously has a, you know, better resume than McCown, but it was probably going to look a certain way if they chose Gannon over Flores or whatever. So, so with that being said, it was like, okay, they probably was like, you know, we probably can't choose y'all, you know, because y'all white and, you know, we're already in enough crap as it is with our image and everything. So, you know, we can try to go with Flores. But I think what happened too, if I remember, I can't remember correctly, but actually, why I don't know why I can't remember correctly, because I think this is exactly what happened. Once they kind of brought in Lovie Smith as like a candidate, once they started announcing and leaking that information that he was getting in all these interviews to be the head coach all of a sudden, I think then that they were safe to say, like, hey, we're gonna cut our ties with McCown on being our coach. And so, that made it seem like, it was he wasn't that they weren't just like cutting away two white candidates, for a black candidate. It's like, oh, we're bringing in a guy that's, you know what I'm saying, that's kind of, just kind of, he's been, he's in the competition somewhat. And he, I mean, he does. And, the way it looks is like, like I just mentioned, his resume, like, it's impeccable. So, of course, they're going to bring him in, and, you know what I'm saying? And if they choose him, then it's going to be like, oh, yeah, we chose Lovie Smith. It's a no-brainer. This guy's been to the Super Bowl. He has all this experience, blah, 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 blah. He's had all the success. So something like that. I think Lovie Smith was a good kind of he was a good and now that I rehearsed this theory before, but now I'm coming in with this other theory. He's just like they say David Culley was supposed to be the scapegoat for why the Texans had a disastrous season. I think Lovie Smith is the scapegoat for why the Texans have had a disastrous coaching search. With the I think the Flores suit, I mean it kind of tilted things a little bit for them, and they really didn't have no control over that. But at the same time, like they had they got caught up. They got caught up in a bad, another bad coaching search for the second straight year. So, hence why, Lovie Smith is probably, the scapegoat for this disastrous search. But, I mean, it's not a bad, person. It's not a bad hire. It's just the whole the circumstances surrounding this hire just, it just kind of dampens things. So, with that being said, other candidates that are some of the other candidates that were kind of just looking forward to a lot of people were looking forward to D'Amico Ryans coming back. I personally wanted I thought when Flores was in the mix, I was like, I either want Flores or I want Kevin O'Connell. And granted, I'll admit I didn't really do my research on a lot of these guys, but I figured like, hey, another Rams assistant, that could turn into something. Another former assistant, Sean McVay, could really turn into something. So, I wouldn't have been mad at that at all. The Josh McCown thing, I just never was with it. I thought that was just, I just felt that there were too many other candidates that had, stronger resumes than him. They had better experience on the sidelines than he did. So I just was not with that at all. So what do I expect from Lovie Smith? So he brings the experience, as I mentioned, Super Bowl appearances, the experience as a defensive-minded coach. So even though I feel like we should have went in an offensive direction, given the situation with Davis Mills and everything, I trust that Lovie Smith will kind of bring in somebody that to kind of oversee all of that. That's familiarity and consistency. He's been with the team for a year, so if he's familiar with the people in the building, familiar with the culture and things like that. So he's probably already been on like 1 year of a job interview, if you will. And I really think with the players knowing who he is and, you know what I'm saying, just probably already comfortable around him, I think it's going to be, it's not going to be a huge shift or shakeup. It's going to be a pretty simple, it's going to be a pretty simple thing. It's going to be something that's pretty simple as far as like transitioning and getting accustomed to. So I don't think there'll be any issues with that. What I do think he'll bring is a, well, I'll get to that about winning later on. What other things I expect, Pep, well, not so much expect, but what I want to see, Pep Hamilton, I want to see where, if he stays, a lot of people have suggested that, a lot of fans have suggested that he becomes the offensive coordinator for us. You know, they like the work that he did with Davis Mills, especially seeing Davis Mills improve towards the end of the season. So they want to see that continue. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, quite frankly, if that's the case, I want to see it continue as well. You know, I was, you know, kind of, I was sketchy on, I'm not ashamed to say, I was sketchy on David Mills, you know, after this season. And, you know, I feel like, I mean, a little, excuse me, a little bit of me still is, but, you know, I want to give him a chance, you know, to get into this offseason and, you know what I'm saying, just kind of see what he can build off on, you know, from these last few games that he's finished. So, like I said, if Pep Hamilton is the source of that, then I definitely want to see Pep Hamilton come back as offensive coordinator, quarterback's coach, if you will, and just kind of, you know, help Mills develop a little bit more. As far as Josh McCown goes, look, if he, I'm not saying that he'll never be an NFL head coach. It's just that right now, it's not the right time for him. You know what I'm saying? Like, it just ain't. It really isn't. And especially with a team like this, you know, you need a veteran coach. You need a Lovie Smith type of coach to come in and kind of, you know, guide this team, you know, through a rebuild. You know, you need a guy to come in there that's had, you know, that success. So, you know what I'm saying, to get players to perform at their highest levels, you know. So, that's not Josh McCown right now. You know, over the years, it could probably be, what, 2 years, 5 years, who knows? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to, you know what I'm saying, I don't want to hate on a man like that has dreams of doing something. And, you know, he seems like he's probably a good dude or whatever. And so you never want to, you know, just try to shoot down, you know, the hopes of, like, you know, good people or kind-hearted people. So, you know, it's just that right now it isn't the time. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I want to say I want that to come off in the nicest way possible, you know, because Twitter ain't been kind. So, but, yeah, I think, you know, they look like they're trying to groom him and to become a coach in the future. So hopefully that works out for him. Last thing, I think that, I really think that Lovie Smith, he's going to bring a better effort at winning. This last season, you know, we obviously, this last season was our tanking season for sure. But, this year, I think that Caserio has a little bit more to work with, as far as draft picks go. If we get those, if we get the Deshaun Watson trade, to go through, I can imagine that we're about to have, like, the greatest selection of picks, that we've had in a while. So whatever he comes out of that, he's gonna have a little bit more collateral to kind of build his team up, and it might have to be through the draft entirely. So hopefully he uses that pretty wisely, and, you know what I'm saying, he gets that really just put together. So, but yeah, I think in addition to that, with, you know, Lovie Smith just, you know, kind of being a familiar face in a new position, I think everybody's going to try to buy into, like, winning this season. So they're going to try a little bit harder. Now, depending on how the roster is set up and all that other stuff through not just draft but free agency, you know, it may or may not be an easy task to do. But I think a lot more effort is going to go towards winning as opposed to just sliding by trying to get into the top three, top five spots in the draft. So that's all I got, man. Those are my thoughts on the Texas hiring Lovie Smith today. I'm Brandon Simmons for BrandonSimmons.biz. Holla black.